this ain't a popular message, and I know y'all know my passion and fire, and you want me to stand here and say we gonna march and burn something up, but that ain't God. And if the truth be told, God knew what was gonna happen before today happened. I need you to understand that God knew who was gonna be in office. He knew who was gonna be in what. He understood this time was coming. He was not caught off guard. And he said, but I've got to have some people in the midst of the chaos who don't mind representing me. Look at that person beside you and ask them, can you still represent God? Can you? And even sitting there today, looking at all of the polls and thinking of all these things, the first thing that we wanted to do was call some folk and find out, what in the world have you done? What the Lord told me, that ain't your job. Your job is to pray, to stand for my people, and to make sure that your behavior is indicative of the spirit that you say you have. Because the Holy Ghost don't just operate when it's things are going your way. That were put in the world for the bad time lose their mind and forget you were made for this. Y'all ain't saying nothing, huh? High five your neighbor, tell them you was made for this. We tell them we were made for this. Lord, this ain't the destruction of the African American race. We've been jacked up for 400 years. And we came out of that. We're going to come out of these 4 years. We're going to be all right. Everything is going to be fine. My concern is not the White House. My concern is the crack house. Y'all ain't saying, my concern ain't who's on Capitol Hill. I want to know what's going on in Newburgh. What's going on in the West End. I'm not concerning myself with all those things. My responsibility and your responsibility is to represent Christ in the world and talk about Jesus to somebody. And the wonderful thing, the privilege that we have is that God continues strengthening us when things get bad. Look at your neighbor and tell him, why are you losing your mind? As a Christian, you got to learn how to pray for folk. You got to learn how to pray and keep it moving. Can I be practical? Because I know my church. I know, Sean. I know the kingdom. He said, I want you to speak. Don't go to Philippians tonight. You got to talk to folk. You got to understand that there's some places, conversations, you don't need to preach. The best thing you need to do is be praying for folk. God has this thing. And if the truth be told, there's not a person in this room that ought to have a sad song to sing. How many know that God is still in control? That's why he said, depending on where you put your trust, if your trust is in a system, when the system shows you what it really is, you're going to be in a state of confusion. But when your trust is in God, it don't matter what the system is doing, I've been called to something greater. Some trust in chariots and horses, but we trust in the name of Jesus Christ. And Paul brings that to Romans 8 because he wants us to understand that the completed work of Jesus Christ ought to drive us in everything that we do. I love so much that statement in Acts when it talks about that early church, and it says, and they continue. In other words, regardless of what's happening, the church must continue. Look at your neighbor and tell them, regardless of what's happening with you, you got to continue. Don't you lose focus through here. Don't you allow the enemy to do something to your mind and you walking around purporting something that is not of God. Truth is, you were saved for this season. Oh, Lord. You were anointed for this season. I was anointed for this season. Why? Because I've got something that I've got to say on behalf of God that somebody out there needs to hear. And I can't get caught up hating folk when I'm supposed to be loving folk. That's one of the principal ways. Can I just talk tonight? That's one of the principal ways you know you're saved. It's the fact you can love folk. It ain't the fact that you can come here and have church. It ain't the fact that you can shout on beat to the praise break. The fact that you know you saved is the fact that you can love people in spite of people. And the reason why you can love all people, somebody say all people. I'm talking to myself, all people. the reason why I can love all people is because I recognize the love that he has for me. And the fact, Lord have mercy, that nothing can separate me from him. No government, no official, no issue, no problem, no demon, no angel, no created being, no principality. You waiting on loving folk when they love you back. You're going to be waiting a long time. Why are you saved? You're just on a trip. The truth is I'm saved and I can love people even when they hate me. Even when they speak against me. That don't mean I stop fighting for rights. That don't mean I stop standing up for people. That don't mean I stop demanding justice. But the truth is I ought not let that evolve or devolve into something God has not called. I felt this strong tonight. I felt this strong tonight. I sat on that couch. I felt a sense of hopelessness. But really, that's like a folk down on Facebook today telling folks, with all that, huh? Y'all not showing no emotion on this thing. God is on the throne. Yes, he is. Name me somebody in scripture that show emotion. David was a man after God's own heart, and he cries all through Psalms. What are you talking about? Jesus was God in the flesh, and in the Garden of Gethsemane was stressed until his sweat turned to blood. Jeremiah, we wouldn't even have a concept of wailing in ministry if it wasn't for Jeremiah. God showed up to Samuel. He said, how long are you going to mourn? He didn't say don't mourn. He said mourn for a season, but guess what? You a prophet. When you come out of mourning, you still got work to do. And I need you to understand tonight, are these perilous times? Absolutely. Are we unsure of what is going to happen from this administration and others? Sure. But the one thing I am not in any way confused about is who has the victory. We talk so much in the church about so many things, and we believe it until some stuff starts happening. Paul said, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. In other words, you've been sent out into this world, and guess what? You have to be successful in your assignment. Y'all didn't want to accept that. When you have the Spirit of God in your life, and you understand your purpose and assignment in this world, you are more able, more than a conqueror, super conqueror. There is no devil in this world that can stop the church.